Hello everyone. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to restore or reinstall apps purchased from the Mac App Store if you're having trouble activating previous in-app purchases using the Restore Purchase button. If you are facing a similar issue and the Restore Purchase button fails to activate a previously purchased app, here is how to resolve it. First, sign in to the App Store on the same device, such as a MacBook, MacBook Air, or iMac, using the same Apple ID and password you used to purchase the app. Next, click Store in the menu bar, select Account, and ensure that you are the one who originally purchased the app. Scroll down to find the app. If you can't find it, you might have used a different Apple ID. In that case, try signing in with your other Apple ID. These are the apps that I had issues with. After confirming the correct Apple ID for the app on the App Store, sign out by clicking Store in the menu bar and selecting Sign Out. Next, open the Applications folder and drag the app you are having issues with to the trash. However, I recommend using a third-party app like AppCleaner or Pearcleaner to uninstall the app and its related files completely from the Applications folder. Both of these apps are very useful and free. To learn how to use them, watch the tutorials at the end of this video. You only need one, so choose the one you prefer and download it.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
After completely removing the app using AppCleaner or Pearcleaner, empty the trash and restart your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac, or Mac Mini. Next, sign in to the App Store using the same Apple ID and password you used to purchase the app. Then, find the app by entering its name in the search box, for example, battery monitor, redownloading it, and then opening it. This method worked for one of my applications. After redownloading and opening it, I could use it without any issues. For my other app, I had to click the Restore button after opening it to access the Pro version. In any case, you may need to click or press the Restore Purchase button again, and hopefully you will be able to continue using your app without further issues. Finally, I would like to bring a couple of important points to your attention. First, when you drag an application to the trash without using an uninstaller app, not all files related to the app may be deleted after emptying the trash. That's why I recommend using an uninstaller to ensure that apps are removed completely. Second, when using the AppCleaner application to remove an app, you might encounter a pop-up message that says, "You don't have permission to move the files to the trash." If this happens after clicking the Remove button, click OK, then click the magnifying glass to reveal the file or folder in the Finder and manually drag it to the trash. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.